second application filled due to uniformly charged infinitely extended thin sheet. In this case, the first part of this thin sheet. Here this thin sheet is shown, both are equally likely, only the difference is here the Gaussian shape surface is in the parallelopiped form and here cylindrical form, no difference at all. So let us assume sigma be the surface charge density of the infinitely extended sheet on both the sides. Here this parallelopiped enclosure this much zone having area say dA and its surface charge density is sigma, so charge is total charge enclosed by this zone is dq equal to sigma dA, that you can write dq is equal to enclosed charge is equal to sigma into dA, equation number 1, that we can consider both the, here also the same thing, dA is the area, sigma is the charge, same charge can be used both the sides, thin sheet is there. Here what NCERT has done, both this length taken x and minus x. Even if these two lengths are not same, the electric field will be same. Even you can show it very well. Suppose at two different points you are going to find out the electric field, whether here is say E1 and here E2. We can show that these two are same. They are taking for equal length same value of electric field, but it is independent of distance from the infinitely extended thin sheet. Let us assume from here this distance is x1. And for this second position is at distance, second is at distance x2. Try to enclose these two on two sides of an hypothetical cylindrical shape or Gaussian surface. Due to this positive charge plate, the electric field here is in this direction and area vector for this surface is also in this direction, so E2dA. For this, E1 is rightward due to this thin sheet, E1, and area is in this direction, dA. For curved surface, area is outward normal all the time and electric field always rightward. So what you see, for whole curved surface area is normal, electric field is tangential. So for this, the flux will be equal to 0. In any phi equal to EBA cos 90 and thus it will be always be 0. So no contribution of these two flux. Here for these two, here phi is EDA cos 180 degree or cos 180 degree is minus 1. So that is equal to minus E1 is there, so E1 dA, so minus E1 dA. Here the flux for through this cap, so flux is equal to E or E2 and D are in the same direction, so E2 dA cos 0 degree. Cos 0 is 1, so E2 into dA, this is on this face. Now what you can do, the total flux if you are going to add up, so total flux is due to this surface, minus E1 dA. For this surface, it is 0. For this surface, this is E2 dA. So total flux is this much. And you know, in this enclosed zone, there is no such charge. So Q enclosed is 0. So at the place of phi, you can write 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed. Charge enclosed is 0. And from here, it is E2 minus E1 into dA. So from here, E2 minus E1 is equal to 0. So E2 is equal to E1. That is what we have to show. So whatsoever at two different distances from thin sheet or infinitely extended thin sheet, we can say that so that electric will always be same, irrespective of distance. At two different distances, though NCERT is taking x and minus x, they are taking same electric field. Even the distance will or length will not be same, the electric will remain the same. This is the first part of the question. Though this will not be a part of the proof of this sheet. Now what we are going to do, we are going to prove it. Our motto. So I am going to erase this one to prove our result. So this I am going to erase. So whether the length of the parallelopiped or this Gaussian cylinder will be same or not, electric field will always be same. Now let us try to start. Here the enclosed zone is this.
charge is this much, we know. So what would be the value of electric field due to this? You know from Gauss's law, the flux phi is equal to integral E dot ds or dA. Here the Gaussian shape is this. Either you take this one or this one, both are equally correct. Here four faces we have. On this side, electric field and area vector in same direction. On rest of the faces, electric field will always be rightward. At the top, upward. At this side, normal. Again at the bottom, downward. But electric field rightward. At that side, electric field rightward, but area vector away from me. And here also, area vector this, electric field this. And on this face, area vector towards me, electric field towards left. On that side, area vector away from me, electric field towards left. On downward face, area vector downward, electric field away from me. And from this side, electric field is this, area is this. So what we see, due to these four sides, there is no such contribution of flux. In all the four sides, though two horizontal sides, two vertical sides, there is no contribution. Here also two horizontal, two vertical, no contribution. Except the two edge, or two ends. These two are going to contribute. So what is the flux? Flux due to two ends. That is the net flux contribution. And how we are going to find out? Due to rightmost face and due to leftmost face, this side. Rightmost face E and dA are same. Even if you are taking E1, E2, these two will be same. So rightmost face E1 or E into dA. Both are in the same direction. Here also E and dA are same. Even if you are taking both negative, finally it will be positive. So here also E into dA. Both are having 0 degree. So finally you have E dA and here also E dA. Result will be 2E dA. This is the flux for in this case. What is the charge enclosed? Charge enclosed is this. See dq. So as per Gauss's law, phi is 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed. What is the value of charge enclosed? You have just written dq. As sigma equal dq of dA, you have learned this in electric field or continuous charge distribution, it is better to say. So here dq is sigma dA, so it will be 1 by epsilon naught times sigma dA. This is the flux. Due to the enclosed charge in this zone. Even if you are going to find out for whole, you can find out for total. The total charge enclosed is this much. The same charge is seen from both the sides. So if you are equating these two, 1 and 2, you shall have 2E dA is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times sigma dA. These dA cancelled out. So you are left with sigma by 2 epsilon naught. What you see here, it is not a function of distance. So what you can say that it is in irrespective of distance, the electric field will always be same. So on both the sides, if you are going to draw the graph of E versus R, that always be a constant quantity. But what value? It is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. In case of this, that will always be constant. So what we see here, that electric field due to a thin sheet is independent of distance. Though if sigma is here, it should be extended. If case 1, if sigma is greater than 0, electric field is directed away from the sheet. So electric field directed away. And if sigma is less than 0 or negative charge, then sigma electric field is towards the plate. So the better way to write in vector form is E is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught into N. If this N is along the area vector or away from it, so in this direction N is. If N sigma is positive towards, sigma is negative away from N. So first case. Second case, if we instead of infinitely extended sheet, if we are taking large sheet, then will this formula be not correct? Of course it will be correct if we are going to ignore if large seat is taken and we are finding out near to the middle point of the seat and end effects are ignored, then this formula is approximately a correct one. Now this was the first, just a minute, I would like to explain it once again. Thin seat is there, flux is due to this end here also in the same way, this is going to provide flux E and DA in same direction, this is going to provide E and DA, that is what I have written EDA, EBA. Due to curved part, E and DA are 90 degrees, so there is no such contribution, so I have not written. Here also, this flat, this perpendicular, so all the sides, top, bottom, these sides are not contributing, here also the same. So this end, this one, and this one are going to contribute in this flux. So that is why we are getting 2DA. And growth charges here, the same charge is seen from both the sides, so this sigma DA that we are going to use here. Finally, we are getting E equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught for thin seat. Though in exam, for thick seat, none of the question has come till now, but we would like to see it once for thick seat. Thick seat means it is of such a thick value or big value that the contribution of both the sides are there. So charges are generally residing on the outer face. So one thin plate sheets of charge are here and other charge will on the other side. So there are also two ways to do. Someone is using this particular Gaussian surface in such a way that half is outside, half is inside. But I am going to take one more. We are taking cylinder in such a way that it can also be seen from both the sides. So here this area and this area is going to include charge. This is equal to sigma dA. This side is also equal to sigma dA. And electric field E and E dA are both in same direction. Here also E and dA are in same direction. So what E we can say? EDA, EDA, we are getting 2 EDA, the total flux integral EDA. So total flux phi is equal to integral E dot DA is due to these two sides, curved side also obviously 0. So here 2 EDA you are getting. Phi due to this 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed. Charge enclosed this as well as this. So this is sigma DA plus sigma DA. So finally you shall have 2 into 1 by epsilon naught sigma dA is equal to 2 e dA. What you shall have? dA cancelled out, these two cancelled out. So finally you shall have e is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. What you are getting? For thin seat it was sigma by 2 epsilon naught. For thick seat it is sigma by epsilon naught. Just double of this is this. So, for thick seat, if you are going to draw the graph, it will be here. Sigma by epsilon naught. This is for thick seat. Just double of this. And lower one is for thin seat. Though it has never come in exam, but you just think over it. Thick seat means both the sides of charges are being used. Or in other way, some books are giving different way, you can use that one as well. You can copy it down properly, even I had just marked it properly, you just copy it, make the figure once again and try to go through it a number of times so that it should be clear to all of you. Try to see this and copy it down. We are going to find out the electric field due to two parallel plates on the left of both the plates, in between the plates and rightmost side of both the plates. And in this case we are going to utilize the principle what we have learned till now. Suppose any thin sheet of charge, uniformly charged thin sheet, is having charge density plus sigma, then on the right side of it, when we put a positive test charge, it is pushed away. So electric field is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. On left side, if we are putting a test charge, it will be pushed towards left. So electric field is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. In vector form, it is rightmost, that is positive x axis side. So you can put here plus sigma and I cap. It is on left side, so you are going to put minus sign with I cap. In the same way, we are going to explain these two. It is positively charged, so we can use for this sigma 1, the electric field is towards left, and that is E1 is equal to minus sigma 1 divided by 2 epsilon naught I cap. Due to second also, it is in the same direction what we have learned here, that is E2 is equal to minus sigma 2 by 2 epsilon naught. Here, due to first, the positive leave positive in the middle. Here, if you leave test charge, due to first test charge is moving towards right. So, E1 is equal to plus sigma 1 by 2 epsilon naught I cap, and this positive charge will push towards left due to second. So, due to second, the electric field E2 is equal to minus sigma 2 by 2 epsilon naught into I cap. In the same way, towards right, if you leave test charge, these two are pushing it away. So, due to first, the electric field E1 is plus sigma 1 by 2 epsilon naught I cap, and due to second as well, the electric field is equal to plus sigma 2 by 2 epsilon naught I cap. So in rightmost position, the electric field, net electric field is sum of these two. So this sigma 1 plus sigma 2 divided by 2 epsilon naught I cap. In the same way, in the middle, if you see, take the vector sum EM, and that is sigma 1 minus sigma 2 divided by 2 epsilon naught I cap. On the left side, if you are going to sum it up, E left is equal to minus sigma 1 plus sigma 2 divided by 2 epsilon naught I cap. So this is what the total electric field, E on the left side of both the plates, E on the middle of both the plates, E on the right side of both the plates. Now there are a few special cases for these three we are going to see. So case number 1, when sigma 1 is equal to plus sigma and sigma 2 is also equal to plus sigma. On the left side, these two are same, sigma, 2 sigma, that 2 is cancelled out. So on the left side, the net electric field is equal to minus sigma by epsilon naught I cap. It means towards left. Here if you put sigma both, so this is 0, so E on the middle, it is equal to 0. On the rightmost, sigma plus sigma, that is 2 sigma, by so 2 is cancelled out. So E on the rightmost side is equal to sigma by epsilon naught I cap. Now we are coming to second special case. Sigma 1 is equal to plus sigma and sigma 2 is equal to minus sigma. This is the principle of capacitor. Here plus charge and here minus charge given in this plate. Then what will happen? If you are putting here sigma 1 plus, sigma 2 minus, so these two are going to make 0. So on the left side of both the plates, that is going to be 0. The electric field. Here, if you are going to put sigma, 1 is plus sigma, second is minus sigma, so this is sigma minus sigma, that is 2 sigma, 2 cancel out. So E in the middle is equal to sigma by epsilon naught I cap. So this is the in middle of the two plates, in between the two plates. And in the third case, E rightmost, here also if you put sigma and minus sigma, that is going to give you 0. So in the capacitor, what you are going to see in this case, here plus sigma and minus sigma is given. So electric field is from left to, or this plate to this plate, that is home. This is the homework, the sigma 1 is minus sigma and sigma 2 is also minus sigma. That is for you. I discussed, due to plate, on the right side the field is going right, and the left side field is going left, if it is positive. But if it is negative, then you have to think over whatever direction. Just leave a positive test charge. The movement of positive test charge will let you know which direction will electric field. Now when both are positive, this is the electric field in between and rightmost. When one is positive, one is negative, field is going from left to right. So this field is present here in between PM. But what you see, that on this side there is no electric field, and on this side also there is no electric field. Outside the plate, no electric field. In between the plates are there. This question has come into year 2009 in set 2. So there it was given to derive the electric field between the two plates. One is having plus sigma, another is having minus sigma. So what you will do? You will derive the formula for infinitely long uniformly charged thin sheet first, and then you will go for this relation, that is second one only. So first, in if it was 3 marks, the answer would like that. First of all, you derive for thin sheet the formula sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Then you have to go for the second option only, and that will be your answer. Thank you. Numerical on uniformly charged infinitely extended thin sheet. The very first is a charge of 17.7 into 10 to the power minus 4 coulomb. It distributed uniformly over a large sheet. A sheet is there. Now this charge is given. Say positive, I am taking right now. Of area 200 meter square. Its area is 200 meter square. Calculate the electric field intensity at distance 20 centimeter from it. From here, distance 20 centimeter, you have to find out electric field intensity. I have just shown it to you that due to this, electric field does not depend on distance, and the formula due to extended thin sheet, infinitely extended thin sheet, uniformly charged. For this, we had the relation E is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught, and you have the charge value here. So from here only, this is Q by area, surface charge density, divided by 2 epsilon naught. Now you have the data. So Q is, you are given, that is, let this be capital Q. If you are taking here capital Q, it is 17.7 into 10 to the power minus 4 divided by area is 200. And this divided by 2, epsilon naught value is 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 SI unit. So if you divide this, the numerator reduces to 8.85, 17.7 by 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 divided by 2 into 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12. So these two cancels out. So this gives 0.5 into 10 to the power 6, or you can write 5 into 10 to the power 5. The unit is, you are determining what? Electric field. So this is, you have to determine, calculate the electric field intensity, that is the name given. So electric field intensity is Newton per Coulomb. That is what you have the answer. Now the next question. A particle of mass 9 into 10 to the power minus 5 gram. So M is 9 into 10 to the power minus 5 gram. In kilogram it is 9 into 10 to the power minus 8 kilogram. Is kept over a large horizontal sheet. A sheet is there. It is kept over this mass M. Of charge density, this sheet is having charge density sigma, that is 5 into 10 to the power minus 5 coulomb per meter square. That is given. What charge should be given to the particle? Q is equal to what? This particle. So that if released, it does not fall, does not go down. So if it is positively charged, so it's quite obvious to go down, its weight is being balanced. So suppose this is the body, its mass is acting downward, so this QE is going to repel the force due to the electric field of this charge sheet. So this QE is going to balance the weight of this. So you have to find out a charge given to this. So Q is equal to mg divided by E. Now, what is the electric field due to infinitely extended charge sheet? You know, that is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So, mg divided by sigma by 2 epsilon naught. And here, sigma you are given. So, you have mg into 2 epsilon naught divided by sigma. So, now put the values. The values are, m is how much? That is, m is 9 into 10 to the power minus 8 into g is 9.8. into 2 into 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12
divided by sigma. Sigma you have 5 into 10 to the power minus 5. So this value is approximately equal to 3.2 into 10 to the power minus 13. So that is what you have to, this is what the coulomb, this Q is there. Now one more question I'm going to extend in this or attach. If this is given charge positive, so it's quite obvious electron has to be removed. So your homework is how many electrons has to be removed from this body so that it will acquire these many, this much charge over there. So you have to find out this. Now in first part, second part, can it be possible that any charged body is going to be kept downward or just below it so that it will not fall? Try to think over it and what charge should be given to it. Thank you.